on for one today, I haven't looked at the schedule that far.
5:30.
That resolves it, because I, last couple of days, I've been looking in the mirror and thinking, geez, it was only a week, he didn't cut my hair short enough. But also, but Evan, there was a big stir back there earlier about the Federal Reserve and the whole system, whether it's.
Yeah. Chamber continues to support you, I think they're gonna even not oppose us on the minimum tax.
And make it plain that we're not imposing taxes, the tax is already imposed. We're just, I've seen recently they're beginning to drift into calling it that we're. All right.
How are you?
It's gonna stay.
It's good.
So that one, you got what you want?
Yes, sir, I think we'll take one more here, here we go.
Thank you very much.
All right.
We wanted one of these, and we wanted you to sign, could you do that?
Have you seen this yet?
It's a young friend of yours.
You know, it's the most, yes, of course, yeah.
But the ladies.
Right down this corner.
This was, after the inauguration, I picked that up in New York, and imagine my amazement to see my picture there.
What's the young fellow's name?
Oh, Fred, just Fred, yeah.
Oh, he'll be thrilled, that's great.
Good, thank you so much.
Very good.
Well.
How much time we get? Any?
He's got about 2 minutes, he's got to be.
Oh, Lord, yes.
Oh, I know how it goes.
Oh, Lord, the National Board of.
We won't keep you, but I've been in town for 5 days, and I'm gonna drop you, run into some things.
Mr. President, how are you? I'd like you to meet Fred Harrison.
Yeah, Mr. President, thank you for letting me come and have his picture made in NLC badly.
Well.
All right. Thank you so much. How you doing?
Well, all right, I guess.
Thank you, sir.
Doing good, doing work.
All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks, sir.
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
I'm not boycotting the meeting, I just have another appointment, so.
Well, please. And you're all here, I know you've been briefed, so I'm not gonna try to plow around what you have. Going over, I do want to say also thanks very much, because I know the support that you gave, and you were among the first, if not the first, to really endorse what we were trying to do. And I think we'd be better off if we had a dialogue instead of a monologue. I know the feeling that you have with regard to revenue sharing, and that's in our '83 budget. But I assume that you've been talking about our federalism.
Yes.
It's kind of on our minds, and we, and it's been explained to you that all we came forward with was a conceptual framework, and we expect to have it fleshed out with the help of the people who would be participating with this, from you and city mayors and county officials and governors. In fact, I've got a list of governors to call that are gonna be meeting here in a few days in Washington, and to kind of remind them of it, we'd like to have them speak to it. But Krieger, why don't you take over?
Well, Mr. President, first of all, I want to thank you for, we're very grateful for you and your staff to allow us to come to Washington and talk to you about the federalism program that you've designed. I'm, of course, the current president of the National Association of Towns and Townships, I'm also elected town clerk in Wisconsin, so I have to stand election too. So, but we want you to know that in February, a year ago, when we were here, we did support the Economic Recovery Program and the Block Grant Program, and We even went to the Hill with that, supported it there.
We can stand some more of that.
We're back here now, and we want you to know that yesterday our board of directors met, and our association wants to be on record as supporting the new federalism program. And I brought you a resolution signed by myself and Bart Russell to prove that. So, I guess we're here to say that we are ready to back and support what you're doing as best we can. We may not disagree with all the specifics, but I think you're going in the right direction, and that's the way we feel about it. We want you to know that. There are others here, of course, from our association, and we want to talk to you a little bit about that. Some questions. So with that, thank you for allowing us to come.
Mr. President, if I might follow our President Krieger. Back in 1976, I worked with Dan Stringer to put together a breakfast for you in Cicero. And at that time, I felt, as did many others, that your programs may be the salvation of small units of government, the small town, the rural parts of America. And I think that's where you had in 1980, and you have today the major, great deal of support. I think our concern now is that in the federalism program, those small towns may not be assured of something for them. In Illinois, for example, the city of Chicago is a local government. We're concerned that perhaps the revenue sharing formula won't be used to allocate funds to the small cities, the small rural communities. That's one of our vital concerns, and we hope that we can convey that to you and to our congressmen. We know that you need the votes on the Hill to get anything done. And we're trying to get that message across back on.
Well, this is why we want all this input, so that we don't suddenly find that someplace along the line someone's fallen through the cracks. But it'll make you feel a little better. I can tell you that I sat at this table with the mayors of the cities, and I have heard repeatedly that they fear the state legislatures are rural-minded, and therefore the cities. We do want the features that will make sure it'll pass. There's no sense in having a federal government, much as I believe in states and having participated in that government, but I can understand the concern. There's no sense in substituting one for the other and then having the same problems and the same lack of flexibility and so forth.
And I represent the Michigan Congress and about 6,500 local elected officials and media past president of NATAP. And we want to thank problems we think with the ACIR, the attempt to put some township officials on that commission. And we appreciate it. We just wonder, though, that in the event that that's unsuccessful, we've been attempting this for the thing that I'd like to bring to your attention, and particularly in prior administrations when things get rough politically, and they always say, well, let's have a series of town meetings. And I've noticed in the past that some of those people, I don't believe, knew what a town meeting was, the third one here in September. And we will be representing 13,000 local communities, and we'll have about 1,000. Extend to you that invitation at this time, and we'll follow it up with your staff, of course. And know that
I hope I can. I have to tell you that I'm still looking for whoever it is that tells me what I'm going to be doing.
And then, just in closing, the Vice President told us what a great guy you were, and we already knew that. I want to say personally, besides supporting you, that I, for one, am thankful that you're
public and caring. My children are going to kill me if I don't give you these Valentines. If you would, for some good news, I hope. By the way, we did watch the press conference. I for one, I think it's around the table. Thought you did.
Lord Waring, of course, sure, it doesn't need an introduction.
Nice to see you.
How you doing, Chateau?
Ah,
hey. How are you? It's good to
meet
you.
Yes, hello.
The bank. I'm the worker. I'm
the bank.
I'm not here just to
sit down.
I had a
Is it for a few minutes?
Well, because that's the only reason I'm here. I don't know how I'm... I don't know how much time you work.
Go ahead.
Yes, honey. Are you gonna have way? AM wine? PEABODY. Yeah, these are our own.
So just a minute, and then Fred's got something to say, and then we'll vote.
It's gonna be kind of interesting tonight because the, based on seniority or however they, oh, that's your pen. However they do it, the leader of the diplomats at the dinner is Dobrynin of the Soviet Union.
Oh, no.
Yes, don't you know that? I guess they do it on numbers of years or something.
Do you realize that Fred and I...